NASA just cracked open a 4.5 billion year old time capsule and found all 5 genetic building blocks, 14 amino acids, and ancient ocean salts. This asteroid sample is basically a cosmic chemistry set. Here's the crazy part. Asteroids are not just flying rocks. They're like space laboratories brewing up life's ingredients. Inside these carbon-rich rocks, water and minerals have been cooking together for millions of years, creating the exact molecules life needs to get started. The Bennu asteroid sample proved this. It contains every genetic building block, plus ammonia and phosphates that make these chemicals actually usable. Even wilder, the Ryugu asteroid delivered vitamin B3 and uracil, showing this isn't a fluke. Today, we're diving into how asteroids might be seeding life across the entire galaxy. Every day, thousands of tons of this organic-rich dust rains down on Earth. Big asteroid impacts deliver bulk ingredients, while gentle dust provides a steady chemical supply. So life might not start from scratch on every world. Asteroids could be the universe's delivery service, dropping off starter kits across the galaxy. But let's be clear about what we're talking about here. This isn't about aliens hitching rides on space rocks. This is about chemistry. Pure, beautiful, life-enabling chemistry. The amino acids found in these samples are what scientists call racemic, which is just a fancy way of saying they're a 50-50 mix of left and right-handed molecules. That's exactly what you'd expect from non-biological processes. No life required, just cosmic chemistry doing its thing. So, how do asteroids become these incredible molecular factories? Well, billions of years ago, the early solar system was a chaotic mess of ice, rock, and organic compounds. Some of these materials clumped together into what we call parent bodies, essentially proto-asteroids with liquid water sloshing around inside. These weren't just static lumps of rock, they were active chemical reactors. Water would seep through porous rock, picking up minerals, heating up, cooling down, concentrating into brines that were saltier than any ocean on Earth. Think of it like a slow cooker that's been running for millions of years, gradually building complex molecules from simple ingredients. The Bennu samples give us the mineral fingerprints of this process. They contain ancient salts that formed when these briny oceans slowly evaporated, leaving behind concentrated deposits of sodium, magnesium, chlorides, and critically, phosphates. Why are phosphates so important? Because life absolutely needs phosphorus, but it's usually locked up in minerals that won't dissolve. These asteroid brines solved that problem billions of years ago, creating bioavailable phosphorus that could actually be used by early chemistry. It's like finding the perfect recipe in your grandmother's cookbook, except your grandmother is 4.5 billion years old and happens to be a space rock. The Bennu findings weren't a one-off discovery. Japan's Hayabusa 2 mission brought back samples from the Ryugu asteroid, and guess what they found? Uracil, one of the RNA building blocks, and vitamin B3, which is essential for metabolism. Two different asteroids, two different missions, same incredible results. But here's what really blew my mind. We've actually been finding this stuff for decades. Meteorites that have fallen to Earth, like the famous Murchison meteorite that crashed in Australia in 1969, contain ribose sugars, diverse nucleobases, and a whole zoo of amino acids. We just didn't fully understand what we were looking at. These aren't contaminated samples that picked up Earth life. Scientists can tell because the isotopic signatures are completely different from anything biological on our planet. These molecules have cosmic fingerprints that scream made in space. So we're not just talking about two lucky asteroid samples. We're talking about a pattern that spans the entire solar system. Organic chemistry isn't rare in space. It's everywhere. Now, how does this cosmic chemistry actually get delivered to planets? There are two main ways, and they're both pretty incredible. First, the gentle approach. Right now, as you're watching this video, Earth is getting showered with tens of thousands of tons of micrometeorites and cosmic dust every single year. These tiny particles heat up as they enter our atmosphere, but they cool quickly enough that many of the organic molecules survive the trip. It's like having a constant sprinkle of life ingredients raining down from space. Then there's the dramatic approach. Massive asteroid impacts. You might think that the intense heat and violence of a big impact would destroy all the delicate organic molecules, but that's not the whole story. The surface material gets scorched, sure, but the interior of large asteroids stays relatively cool. Plus, and this is mind-blowing, impact plumes can actually synthesize new organic compounds from the heat and pressure. So impacts don't just deliver prebiotic molecules, they can create them on the spot. Both delivery methods have been happening for billions of years, not just on Earth, but on every rocky planet and moon in the solar system. Mars gets this treatment. Europa and Enceladus, with their subsurface oceans, get constantly spiked with fresh organic compounds. Even Ceres shows evidence of organic materials mixing with subsurface brines. Here's where things get really exciting. If asteroids are delivering life's ingredients everywhere, then the universe might be far more biologically active than we ever imagined. Every star system with asteroids and rocky planets becomes a potential breeding ground for life. Think about Europa, Jupiter's ice-covered moon. We know it has a vast ocean beneath that icy shell, and we know that organic-rich asteroids have been bombarding it for billions of years. Large impacts may penetrate the ice, while smaller ones deliver organics to the surface, where they could later mix into the ocean through fractures. The same goes for Enceladus, where we've already detected organic compounds in the water plumes shooting out from its south pole. Are we looking at indigenous chemistry, or are we seeing the accumulated results of billions of years of asteroid deliveries? Probably both. And here's a wild idea. Could asteroids actually be carrying living microbes, not just molecules? It's called lithopanspermia, and while it's much more speculative, recent experiments have shown that certain microbes can survive the shock of ejection from a planet. Years in the vacuum of space, and even atmospheric entry, especially when shielded inside large rocks. Surviving for thousands or even millions of years is the big challenge. So asteroids aren't just cosmic debris. They're chemical factories, delivery vehicles, and possibly even lifeboats carrying the ingredients for biology across vast distances of space and time. The universe isn't a sterile, empty place where life has to spontaneously generate against impossible odds on every single world. Instead, it might be an interconnected web where life's building blocks flow freely between star systems. We're not just children of the stars in a poetic sense. We might literally be made from ingredients that traveled across the galaxy in cosmic delivery trucks that we call asteroids. What do you think? Are we alone? Or is the universe actively helping life get started everywhere? Let me know in the comments. And if this blew your mind as much as it did mine, hit that like button and subscribe for more mind-bending science.